everybody. Joan here with Cosmo, and I've had a few requests for a little video on how I teach hold on the dumbbell and other retrieve objects, and so I'm going to do it. So step one, you need what's called a chin rest. And a chin rest is just what it sounds like. It's where the dog puts their head on their chin on your hand and just holds it there for an extended period of time. You build this up very gradually, and you want to make it so the dog really loves this. The chin rest is used for a variety of occasions. One thing it's big on is, good boy, cooperative care for the vet office. That's probably the most useful thing. I find this also creates a calm, more thoughtful dog. So if I have a dog that's running around crazy barking and I want him to just bring it down, a chin will often help them do that. What I'm going to show you though is how I use it to teach a hold with a dumbbell and glove, and then I'm going to show a walking hold. So when you teach your chin rest initially, you want the dog to come into you instead of you reaching out for the dog. Okay? So I'm going to show you that with a little reset cookie here with Mr. Cosmo. Get it. Chin. And I'm just going to lure him right onto my hand. Can you see that? So, get it. Chin. And he's just going to come right in. Get it. Chin. And I just have a cookie standing right where I want his nose to come to. Okay? From that, you're going to go to a little bit more duration, and you're going to get rid of the initial lure. So, air cookie. Here's a real one. Get it. Reset cookie. Chin. Good. I'm going to use a mouth click. If you can do that, that's great. You can say yip. You can say yes, whatever you want to do. And I also hold my cheese in my mouth. Very convenient. Get it. Whoa. Chin. And I want my dog looking up at me, right? So it's really great that I can hold my cheese in my mouth. He knows that's where it's coming from. Like if you want ice cream, you're going to go to the freezer because that's where it comes from. Same with this. If he wants cheese, he's going to come up here because this is where it comes from. You ready? Get it. Chin.
Good boy.
And I actually leaned back a little, so he had to come in a little bit more that time. Okay? You do this, take your time doing this. You really want the dog to love to do this and be very relaxed. Chin.
Good.
Okay. That's a little trick, sorry. He can catch really well. So, ready? Chin. Good. Okay. That's step one. Step two requires my little platform. So y'all know that I have those new platforms at Dog Days. Well, this is all I have at home, and I'm at home. So we want a sit platform that the dog knows to sit on. Come sit. What? Come sit. Wow, that's really good. And at this stage, you have two pieces of foundation behavior. One is that chin rest, right? Chin. Where he's looking at me, ready, chin. Good, okay? That's one. The other one is that you already have a dog who will put their mouth on the dumbbell. Take it, give, good. He already knows how to put his mouth on it just by playing with it, take it. Whatever method, clicker training, whatever method you use, I'm not going to go into that part. That part's usually pretty easy. But what I'm going to do now is show you how I do this. Hold a cookie in my mouth. This is a piece of cheese. It hasn't been on the floor. And I'm going to put the dumbbell in his mouth right where I want it. If it goes too far back, dogs tend to chew back there. So I want to put it right behind the canines. Now I'm going to give him a cookie. That's all there is to this. I'm going to be right here looking at my dog, communicating. Take it. Yes. Good. Kind of already knows this. Good. 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 So I kind of skipped ahead there because he kind of already knows it. Take it. Thank you. I just want to do that. The reason the dog's on the platform is because these dogs already know, just stay on the platform. So you sometimes get a dog that when you give them the dumbbell, they back away or they move to one side or they fling it one way. He'll just sit there because he's got a lot of practice and history sitting in one place on there. So here we go, take it, give, good. So I'm now able to take it, give, good. So he can take it, I can briefly pick my hands off it. Now I want, this is the hardest part, the hold. I'm gonna use his chin, chin. Good, take it, chin, give. So the sequence here is chin, take it, chin, give. Okay, reminding him to keep his chin on there. And his focus goes up here on the cheese. Chin, take it, chin, give. Simple. Takes a while though. This probably took a couple hours. Well, maybe not. Chin, take it, chin, hold, give. So that time he's looking at me, he understood not to chew, not to flip his head. So I said the word hold because he's doing it. As soon as the dog starts doing what you want, start naming it. Take it, chin, chin, hold, give. Okay? Simple, simple and easy. If you build up, chin, take it, hold, hold, chin, give. If your dog lets go of it or looks uncomfortable, stop, put the dumbbell away, and do a little more chin, good. Rewards for chin, chin, good. Get some duration there so the dog is comfortable holding his chin on your hand. Okay? That's video one.